Hey guys, what's up? Greetings from the Botanical Garden in Berkeley, California. That's where I'm hanging out today. And I want to show you this new model I designed. It is, I don't know what to call it, but it's pretty cool. It's a modular model made out of 9 bricks. These I'll call building blocks because you can use them to make a whole variety of different structures. This block, this unit, has 2 flaps and it also has 2 pockets. And so it can be arranged, constructed together to make all different forms. And it's all without any glue or any tape. And yeah, here's another one. So yeah, and I'll show you how to make these, but first, you want to learn how to make this building block. Ready, set, here goes. In this tutorial, I'm just going to show you how to fold this model, which I've named Dancing Dominoes. And hopefully, once you've folded this, you'll be able to figure out how I folded the other two that I showed in the intro, and perhaps even design your own variations. Now, I should warn you, this is a rather challenging project, in particular, attaching the blocks together. But if you're up for the challenge, well then, cool, let's fold. So for this model, we need 4 modules that have 2 flaps, and we need 2 modules that have 1 right flap, and 2 modules that have 1 left flap, and 1 module that has 0 flaps. So I'm gonna start out by showing you how to make the module that has 2 flaps. Here it goes. So for this tutorial, I'm going to use a 6-inch square of hami, which will make a module that looks like this. But if you want, you could use an ordinary sheet of printer paper, and you don't even need to cut it square. Or better yet, you could use a decorative sheet of printer paper. This is a sheet from this pad that I bought at Target, and the dimensions are 12 inches by 9 inches. And it can either make a module that is long like this, or a module that is short, depending on how you orient it. But I'm going to use a 6-inch square of kami. So let's begin white side up, and let's fold in half, but we're just going to make a pinch mark here and here. So align these 2 corners, and make your pinch mark there, and align these 2 corners, and make the pinch mark there, and unfold. Now, if you want a long module and you're using a rectangle, then begin white side up, landscape, and fold in half like this, and make your pinch mark like this, and that will give you a long module. If you want a short module, then begin portrait and fold in half and make the crease like this, and you'll end up with this short module. But I'm using a square, so we just made our 2 pinch marks, and now let's fold this bottom edge to the 2 pinch marks. Try to make your folds really exact and crease them sharply. And now let's rotate 180 degrees and let's fold this edge to here. And unfold. And now let's fold this edge to the top. And unfold, and let's fold the bottom edge to the first crease. And let's rotate 180 degrees, and let's unfold this flap, and let's fold this edge to this edge. And unfold both flaps.
And now let's fold this corner up so that this edge aligns with this crease. And let's do the same thing on the right side. Let's fold the flap up so that this edge aligns with the crease. And let's rotate 180 degrees and let's do the same thing on this side. So fold this flap up so that this edge aligns with this crease. And fold this flap up so this edge aligns with this crease. And let's rotate 90 degrees. And let's fold this edge up so that the crease line goes right on these two edges. And really try to be careful to make sure that they go right on the edges. Like this, and like that. It looks like a ghost. There's the mouth and the two eyes. And let's rotate 180 degrees. And let's fold this edge up to here. Okay, and now let's unfold the two flaps. And now we're going to valley fold this triangle in half. So hold it like this, and let's bring these two corners together so that they touch, and just fold the triangle in half, like that. And now let's repeat on the other three triangles. So rotate, and let's fold the triangle in half so that these two corners touch. And rotate, and fold in half. And one more triangle. And now let's flatten it. And now let's rotate it until this crease is closest to you. Notice that there's not a crease here, here, or here. So let's fold this edge up on this existing crease. And now let's fold this right flap in on this existing crease. And let's do the same thing on the left side. Let's fold this flap in on this crease. And now let's rotate so this white triangle is nearest to you. Now we're going to make a diagonal fold right in this square. And here's how it's going to look. So we first want to make a mountain fold right here on the top layer. So we have this fold, and we're going to fold this to this edge, making this diagonal valley fold. So it looks like this. Make sure that the fold comes right to this corner and the edges align. And make the fold. Okay, so that's what it should look like. And now let's do the same thing on this side. So let's make this fold, and let's fold it to this edge. So just bring the two edges together so they align, and make sure that the edge aligns with this crease right here. And make the fold. And now let's unfold, and let's rotate 180 degrees, and we're going to do the same thing on this side. So let's make this fold right here, and let's fold it down to this edge. Make sure that the fold goes through this point right here. Like that, And let's do the same thing on this side. So let's make this fold and let's fold it to this edge. Make sure it goes through this point. And make the fold. Okay. Now we're going to fold right on this crease. We're going to make a valley fold on the existing crease, and we're going to fold this corner all the way to the back. And so let's first make this mountain fold, and now let's fold this corner all the way to the back like that. And to make it stay, let's bring this flap up like this. And let's do the same thing on this side. So let's make this fold right here, and let's bring this corner all the way to the back, like that. Okay, so this is what it should look like. Oh, and we want to lift this flap up so that it locks in place. And now let's fold this, these two points in. We're wrapping the paper around this edge and this edge. So here it is, just fold this paper inside like that. And now let's just push these two points down. And there we have the completed module. And now we have to do this three more times. All right, so now you should have four modules that have two flaps. And now I'm going to show you how to make the modules that have one flap. So it starts the same way. Okay, now when you fold this triangle in half, now you want to reverse it so it becomes a mountain fold. So we're making a genderless crease, meaning it's not a valley crease, it's not a mountain crease, it's just a crease. And now let's make genderless creases on the other three triangles. Okay, and now let's continue as before. Now when we get here, the idea is that one of these is going to push in and the other is going to push out. So let's push this side out and let's push this side in. And now what we have to do is we have to insert this flap into this pocket. And this isn't very easy, but I'm going to try to do it very slow and carefully so that you can see it. So we're going to take this flap and stick it into this pocket. So just tuck it right into the pocket, like this, and slide it in. And now this point goes into the pocket like the normal two-flap module, just like that. So here we have the single flap module, and now we just need to make one more of these, and then make one that has the flap coming out on the left, and make another one of those, and you'll be all set. Ideally, we want all of the flaps to be on top. So this one is a right flap, and this is a left flap, and this is a left flap, and this is a right flap. Okay, so here we have with two flaps and with one flap, and lastly, the one with no flaps. So it starts the same way. Now with this one, you just need to mountain fold the triangle in half. And the same on the other three triangles. And now continue the same. But for this, let's start with the triangle on top. And same thing. And rotate. And same thing. Okay, so we have it like this, and now we're going to fold these both in, like this, and this is going to fold down, like that, and then this is going to go right on top of it. I made a separate tutorial for this model right here. Okay, so it's like that. And now this flap goes into this pocket right in there. And this flap goes into this pocket. And it locks like that. All right, so you should now have four modules that each have two flaps, two modules that each have a flap on the right, and two modules that each have a flap on the left, and one module that doesn't have any flaps. Now let's fold each flap outward. So let's fold this point to this crease. right like that, and make it nice and sharp. And let's do that on all of the flaps. Just fold them outward. Like that. And let's do the same thing on all of the flaps. Okay, and now let's turn them like this. And now we're going to reposition them. So this is the one that's on top, and these two are on the sides, these two flap ones, and this one flap one is here, and this one flap one is here, and we have a two flap one that goes right there, and a one flap here, and a one flap here, and the no flap here. All right, so with this arrangement, you see that each flap has a pocket to slip inside, and that's what we're going to do. So let's put this flap into this pocket, but first let's open up this module so that we can see this flap. This is the flap that it's going to go inside of, and here goes. So let's put it inside like that. Okay, and now we're going to lift this flap up like this, and we're going to fold it right on the existing crease that we made on the other module's flap. So it's just like that, and that locks it. And yeah, so there it is. And now let's close it up. And now we're going to stick this flap into this pocket right here. So let's open up this module and stick the flap inside and grab on to the inside module, and we have to fold this thing right along the same crease that we made. So just fold it like that. And yes, this isn't very easy, but it's pretty cool at the end. And now we just need to put it back together like this. Okay, now let's put this flap into this pocket. Oh, but let's first open up this module. And now let's put the flap into the pocket. And fold it over. Like that. And close it back up. Okay, and now let's put this flap into this module. So open it up. And fold it over on the existing crease. And these are connected. Okay, now let's do this middle one. So open it up. So open the pocket, stick the flap in, fold it over. And now let's stick this one into this pocket. Lift it up and hold it over like that. And let's close this guy back up. Okay, now we're going to stick this flap into this pocket. So make sure that this flap is on the right. Okay, and let's do the same thing over here. Stick this flap into this pocket. And fold. And let's close this guy back up. And now let's close this guy back up. And let's stick this flap into here. Oh, let's open this up first. Make sure that this flap is on the left. Okay. And stick this guy in. And let's close this guy back up. And last but not least, our module that doesn't have any flaps. Let's open it up. I don't think I folded this one. Okay, here goes. And last one. And let's close this guy back up. And there it is. And now just make sure that all little glitches are out. And we're done. You can exercise it, like first get it in this position, and then in this position. And the more you exercise it like this, the better it will operate. And after you do that a few dozen times, then you can hold right here, and there it is, the dancing dominoes. So yeah, I hope you guys were able to hold this. I know it was a marathon of a modular model, but I think it's pretty cool. So hope you guys liked it, and I'll flex you later. Bye-bye.